All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another upcoming content video. My upcoming content series is where I go over upcoming content released by Gaijin on their dev blog or other sources. My upcoming content series is not here to give you a historical background on the units shown, but is simply here to tell you this is coming to War Thunder to give you an idea of what it may be like. Oh my god, Gaijin, I love you. I hated you because you're giving the Soviets another multi-turreted tank, but then you did this, and now I love you again. This is the Panzerbefehlswagen VI Tiger P. Sorry, I had to call it the Befehlswagen because reasons. Okay. The Panzer VI Tiger P. Oh! Man, have I wanted this in the game since the game first released. Me and friends, whatever. I don't grammar properly. We have always talked about this thing, and if it was in War Thunder and whatnot, and how amazing it would be to drive this thing, and now it's coming to War Thunder. Oh my god. So, this thing carries the normal 88mm gun, and it should actually be faster. See, the real thing would, had, you know, because of the engines and the way the design of the engines and whatnot, and the kind of fuel it used, would break down easily, very easily. But in War Thunder, you don't get those mechanical problems. At least you don't get them yet. Even in simulator, you don't get engine problems, you don't have any, you know, crew problems, you don't have any problems like that. Although, for World War mode, I would like to have those, where if you're driving this thing, the engine would break down every 5 minutes, but, you know, whatever. So, in-game, because the engine won't break down, this thing should have a... should be moving faster than a normal Tiger. A normal Panzer VI Tiger. Which is, I mean... you know, this is great. I don't know what battle rating it's going to sit at, but if this thing could move faster than the Panzer VI Tiger, though it's not going to be as, you know, well-armored or easy to use, I mean, because, well, the Tiger... Tiger 1... the Panzer VI, the one we all know, the Henschel variant. That thing is, I mean, it's thick armor, it's big and square, and it's not as long as this little tank here. I mean, when you look at it, it's very long. It's got a lot of back space there, and it's also got that antenna there. But another thing to take a note is if you're looking forward to this vehicle just as much as I am, you're going to need Golden Eagles because this is going to be a German premium unit. And that makes sense, but this is going to be a German premium unit. The first German premium unit to have an 88mm that is turreted, instead of the other Befehlswagen, the Jagdpanther premium variant. So, again, if you're looking forward to this thing, make sure to have Golden Eagles. So, there you go, new premium units for both the Soviets and the Germanies. Still no new aircraft for the United States or the Germans. Or British. Actually, no, the British did get that Canberra. So we have the Americans. Sorry, Americans actually isn't the proper term. We have the United States and the Germanies that still don't have any new aircraft. But we've got new ground units for Soviets and Germans, and new aircraft for British, Soviets, and Japanese, but still nothing for the United States or Germany. If you guys want something aviation added to the game, post down below what you would like to see added to the Germans, whether that's an Italian aircraft. I know a lot of people want a lot of those different Italian aircraft, or if that's a United States aircraft. You know, post down below what you would like to see. Excuse me. One thing I really want them to add is the ME-209, or BF-209, which was a prototype blueprint design for the next in generations. That would be an amazing thing to fly around in. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and join me in the next upcoming content video.